lecture today is going to try to touch on a sugya, which is a sugya which has to do with Pesach. Has to do with Pesach, has to do really with all mitzvahs asay, and also the rabbanans. We talk about a concept which is mentioned in Shulchan Aruch that talks about the kavana in mitzvahs. A kavana, that you have to have intent to do the mitzvah. I'm going to talk about it, the several nekudas, and try to, in a short time, to get to answer some very difficult questions which are raised in this sugya. So on the first page, we mentioned, really, we could talk about three inyanim. About the first one, mitzvah tzrichas kavana, or ein tzrichas kavana. When you do a mitzvah, is it necessary to think about that I'm doing a mitzvah? Or let's say I'm doing it without thinking that it's a mitzvah. I just did it without thinking about it. Am I yotze the mitzvah or not? That's the first question. And the second question, second in you talk about, is there a difference between a mitzvah deraisa and a mitzvah derabonin? If we say that mitzvah is tzrichas kavana, perhaps you only need a kavana, you do a deraisa mitzvah. Like you do a sukkah, lulav, shofar, a deraisa, but maybe not a derabonin. Perhaps in the Rabbanan, when you eat the Morer and the Seder, or you read the Megillah, it could be that you don't need Kavanah. And the third question, the third we're going to deal with, is the Rambam Shita. The Rambam is a very difficult Rambam in the halachas of Mitzvah Tzrichas Kavanah. The Rambam, discussing the din of Mitzvah Tzrichas Kavanah, the Rambam says that if you're forced to eat matzah, kafu parsiyim, goyim forced them to eat matzah. And small question, goyim forced them to eat matzah, maybe they thought it was chometz, a big shayla in the Mefarshim, what exactly was the reason that goyim forced them to eat the chometz. But the Rambam talks about that case in the Mor Shoneh, that the goyim forced them to eat matzah, maybe they didn't know it was matzah, they didn't know it was a mitzvah, whatever, some reason they forced them to eat it. And he ate the matzah. So the Rambam says that it's yaitzah mitzvah. Seems like he had no kavana. They were forcing him to eat it. He didn't seem to have any kavana to eat the matzah. He's sitting in prison there, or he's in prison by the goyim. Doesn't seem to know that it's even it's a shayla in the Rishonim, the Rambam brings, whether he knew it was chometz, whether he knew it was Pesach, whether he knew it was matzah. Forced him to eat it. It's yaitzah. But the Rambam says there that if you want to be yotze shofar, you have to have kavana to be yotze the mitzvah. You have kavana, the person who's blowing the shofar should have kavana to be yotze, the person who's listening, and the listener has to have kavana to be yotze the mitzvah. So that's the Rambam. So the question of the Rambam, all the Mefarshim, the great Mefarshim on the Rambam, the Magen Mishnah, the Lechem Mishnah, the Kesem Mishnah, they all are wondering, what exactly is the Rambam Shita in mitzvahs? Do you need kavana? The Rambam says you don't need kavana. The Rambam says you force them, the goyim force them to eat it. It's yotze the mitzvah matzah. And then the Rambam says in Shofar, you have to be mechaben to be yotze the mitzvah, and he has to be mechaben to be motzi you, he has to be mechaben to be yotze. Seems like you need kavana. So that's the question that we have to discuss, several questions. In the sheets that were gave out over here, in the first page, you go on to the next page there, the kunchus bini kavana sa mitzvah. This kunchus was by Reb Osher Weiss, famous Reb Osher Weiss. Many of you went to the Siyam HaShas last year, about a year ago. He was brought in from Eretz Yisrael to speak. He's one of the big poskim in the world today. He has Minchas Osher. Did I know Minchas Osher? He has at least 19 Svarim and Aloche, and more Svarim, not on Aloche also, many Svarim. In the Inyan of Mitzvah Tzrichas Kavanah, he has about a Shtikul Torah, maybe 30, 40 pages on this Inyan. So it's a lot. We're not going to talk about all those pages. Talk about some of the points. On the first page, he brings the Machlokas Amaroyim in the Sugya Rosh Hashanah, the beginning of that second page, Machlokas, whether Mitzvah Tzrichas Kavanah or not Tzrichas Kavanah. And he brings the Das of the Rambam of the Rif. Seems like that Mitzvah Tzrichas Kavanah, like we mentioned before, that you Yotze with Shofar only if you had Kavanah to be Yotze. The Balamor and the Rav Haigol, they say you don't need Kavanah for Mitzvahs. You Yotze without Kavanah. So big Machlokas Rishayim, whether you need Kavanah or you don't need Kavanah. And the middle paragraph there on the first page, Kosa Tabina Reyna, so per Kavadi Brochis. That Kano Nechaku Ella Lagabi Bidi Ebed, Im Yotze Yede Chavose. So the Rebbe Yaina explains that this Oinin of having Kabbana about a mitzvah is only about whether you're Yotze Bidi Ebed. If you didn't have Kabbana, you'd be Yotze. Abba Lechat Chile, for sure, when you go in to do a mitzvah, l'chatchila, l'kuli alma, everybody would agree, tzorech kavana. You certainly have to have one. Uba emes, it's an interesting chiddush on Ben Yonah. Milsa de pshitahi, ve'en b'zeh kol chiddush. He says, I'm saying something very simple. There's no chiddush in what I'm saying now. The ani is 90 poshet. That's like it's an expression in the Gemara that you know the eggs in milk, it's kosher. So he says that it's so simple, everybody knows this, that tokeil ashir, afim yotzi dechabasi, even if a guy was blowing he likes the sound. Some people, you know, they make noise with a shofar, they can blow it, you know, and he's just practicing the sounds. He's not doing it for the mitzvah. Im yotzi dechabasi, it could be that you yotzi the omer mitzvah saying tukas kabonet. In biyada lo schar mitzvah, velo meskulas ha mitzvah. He doesn't get rewards, says Rabbi Yonah. He doesn't have any of the skula. Sometimes, besides a schar for a mitzvah, there's skulas a mitzvah. You get certain, brownie points upstairs. To do a mitzvah, you get brownie points. He says, you don't get the schar, you don't get the brownie points. And be'enon nikra ovid Hashem klal. If you didn't have kavana, you're not ovid Hashem. And the Abraham, aveira b'yodei. It's even a bad thing. Chari iskabe in labor al shvus, because blowing a horn on a yontev, on Rosh Hashanah, blowing a horn is the issur d'rabbanan. You're not allowed to blow a horn. It's not a deraisa, but it's issur d'rabbanan. So if you didn't have a kavanah to do a mitzvah, you're over even d'rabbanan. So it's a bad thing, he says. No, you have no schar mitzvah. And you have no skulas mitzvah. And you even did a bad thing. He says, b'sar kleh. It's like the Gemara talks about a person, he had kavanah to eat not kosher food, and it turned out it was not kosher. You know, sometimes, I'm going to this trade restaurant, turned out it was a kosher restaurant. So he doesn't get a mitzvah, it's an aver, the Gemara says. Here also, the guy thought he's doing, he's playing the horn, he's blowing the horn, and he thought he's blowing the horn, but he didn't think he's doing a mitzvah. So he says it's like the guy did a aver. Okay, anyway, so not doing it with kavana is certainly not a very good idea. Whether you go to or not, there's another shaila. Okay, that's number one. Let's go to page three. The next thing is the mitzvah rabbana, it needs kavana or not. So over here, and it says Os Gimel there, and right under it says Os Gimel on the right side. Kosovo Mogad Avram. So Mogad Avram, one of the great poskim in the Or Chaim, the Mogad Avram says, in Simon Samach, Gimel, brings the Shimon Radvaz. Dirak b'mitzvah d'oraisa tzorech kavana v'lo mitzvah d'rabbanan. It doesn't explain the reason. It brings a Radvaz, and it's not so clear exactly where this Radvaz is. Rav Asher Weiss says he didn't find the Radvaz. He says he saw it. Radvaz says he's not exactly 100% sure where the Mogad Avram picked this up on, but he looked into a lot of Radvaz. He said, I checked it. I'm not 100% sure, but we can rely on the Mogad Avram. If he said he followed it, it's there, you know. So the Mogad Avram says that it's different between mitzvah d'oraisa and mitzvah d'rabbanan. A mitzvah d'oraisa, he says you need kavana. A mitzvah d'rabbanan, you don't need kavana. Okay? Now, explained on that, right? And then see with Os Gimel, the third line. We're talking about the heavy hitters in the Shulchan Aruch. Rav Kiv Eiger is quoting the Prima Godin. B'taymoy. The ma'amis was safkelon halacha. In mitzvah tzrikas kavana, o ain't tzrikas kavana. The mitzvah d'oraisa, arminim tzvek d'oraisa, l'chumra. The mitzvah d'rabbanan, tzvek l'kula. Oh, he says, why is it true? There's a difference between a mitzvah d'rabbanan and a mitzvah d'oraisa. He says, because we know there's a rule there's that if a mitzvah sofik d'oraisa l'chumra and a sofik d'rabbanan l'kula, right? That's the rule. Sofik d'oraisa l'chumra, sofik d'rabbanan l'kula. And says the Prima Godin, we're mesupik, but we just saw the Gemara. There's a machlokus in the Gemara between the Amorayim, whether mitzvah snichas kavana or mitzvah kavana. So since it's a sofik in Gemara, he says it's something we saw in halacha. It's a machlokus also b'sheinim. Machlokus the Rambam, the Balamor, whether you need kavana or you need kavana. So he says in a mitzvah deraisa, since we say a rule of sofik deraisa chumra, so if you got to have kavana because it's sofik deraisa chumra. In a derabbanan. In the Rabbanan, so let's say eating more on the Seder or doing other mitzvahs to Rabbanan, something he didn't do it, so it could be Mekel, because some of the Rabbanan Kula. That's what the Rabbi Eger says in the name of the Prima Godin, explaining this halacha of the Mogad Avram and Shiva Radvaz. Again, so there's a mitzvah in the Gemara Amoraim, and it's a machlokes of Rishonim, how we paskin. And then we have also a difference between the Raisa and the Rabbanan. The Mogad Avram says the Raisa you need kavana, the Rabbanan you don't need it. And Rabbi Gedeger explains because it's a suffix, really, whether you need kavana or kavana, it's something Raisa Lakura, it's something Rabbanan Lakula. That's how Rabbi Gedeger explains. But it's mentioned over here in the next paragraph, in the middle paragraph on that same page. Achlepizeh, if you're on the same page with me, the middle paragraph over there, I could show it here on the screen over here. Those who are looking, I forgot about my screen over here, but if those are on the screen, they can see it over here. We have a lot of people sitting here. So on the screen, you can see it right over here in front of us. In this middle of the screen, Achlafizeh. If you can see it, I can make it larger also. But it says over there, Achlafizeh. Sosar HaPrimigodim is Tevorov. He says that it seems to be a contradiction in the words of the HaPrimigodim. The Mishnah Samas, you've got the Ches, Hevi, HaMishnah Bura, B'Shem HaPrimigodim. The Mishnah Bura quotes the HaPrimigodim. That is Subic, Im Ki Vein La, Libo B'Mitzvah D'Raisa, Tzorch Lach Zol HaKaimah, Shun Svegi D'Raisa L'Chumra. So the Mogen Avraham, he quotes, he says, the HaPrimigodim, it says, the HaPrimigodim, the Mishnah Bura quotes the HaPrimigodim. He says that the Mogen Avraham has a Suffolk, whether if you're a mechaben and a mitzvah deraisa, whether you should go over that, Tzorch Lach Zol HaKaimah, he says you have to do it, Shun Svegi D'Raisa L'Chumra. And he says, but a mitzvah d'rabbanan is suffix, so then you go to kula. Again, we're talking now a suffix whether you had kavanah or you didn't have kavanah. So a suffix, if you had kavanah, you did a mitzvah. I don't remember if I was mechavan. I did a mitzvah. I don't know, you know, maybe I was, you know, I wasn't really mechavan. Sometimes, you know, late at night, you go to sleep. Tonight you should daven Myra, by the way. Also, those who are going to leave early here from the yeshiva, you know, they out because of PTA, you get done at 4:30 today. So I suggested that people could stay a few more minutes. Plug on Minchas, like 4:38 or 4:39, something like that. Maybe you get Dav Meirv over here, so you shouldn't forget Dav Meirv, because you know, you leave early. Those are the seniors, I think they leave earlier, but the other boys, when you leave at 4:30, wait a couple more minutes, plug on Minchas a few minutes later, so you can just make a minion here in the yeshiva, unless you get later minion, you know, later go home and get a minion. But if you're not going to get a minion, maybe just wait around a few minutes and get a minion here, and that's what I suggested. So you ask your Rabbi, I'm asking your Rabbi Zerim and the others, they think this is a good idea and they can do it. What? You mentioned it? Okay. So now the Primigodim says that in the mitzvah deraisa sofik, but you're yotze, not yotze, you're yotze. You don't, you're not yotze, you gotta go over it. And a sofik and the rabbanan, so I was practicing. A guy was practicing reading the Megillah. The guy, you know, he has to go to shul and he's practicing. He wants to do it. You know, some guys they do it a lot of laning. So I was practicing. And then all of a sudden, hey, did I have kavanah? You know, I was practicing. I didn't realize I was doing this for a mitzvah. So he said, well, the rabbanan, because Megillah is a sofik in the daytime. Maybe it's the Beit Kabbalah, maybe it's the deraisa. Well, let's call it the rabbanan for sure. The nighttime, the rabbanan. So a sofik, he says, rabbanan, it can be sofik the other kula. So ask for Usher Weiss, he's asking the following question. We have a rule, svek sveka is lakula. Even on a dinda raisa, a svek sveka, a double suffix is we go lakula. So he said, look, we got a svek sveka here. Why? Because we have a suffix again, according to the Rebbeinu, we have a suffix whether every mitzvah needs kavanah or doesn't need kavanah. So suffix, right? Suffix, that's how Primigodim, that's how Rebbeinu quotes Primigodim. According to Primigodim, every mitzvah is a suffix whether you need kavanah or not. Okay, suffix. Now, it's a suffix. My suffix on a mitzvah deraisa, I'm the suffix whether I had kavanah, didn't have kavanah. Again, I did a mitzvah deraisa. I did a mitzvah deraisa now. I said Kriya Shema at night. But maybe I was just, practicing. I was, you know, playing. I was teaching my kid how to say Kriya Shema. Was I really mechavan to go to a mitzvah? I was just practicing teaching my kid. I wasn't really doing a mitzvah. So it's a suffix. So he says, well, suffix deraisa l'chumra. He says, why suffix deraisa? It should be a svek sveka. Suffix whether. Why is svek sveka? He says, because a suffix whether I said it or didn't say it. Suffix whether I said it. He says, suffix, two svekas, right? He says, a suffix, I said suffix, it's a suffix whether you need kavanah altogether. That's a suffix. Because we say that in every mitzvah according to the Primigodim, it's a suffix whether you need kavanah. So it's a suffix whether I need kavanah. Maybe I don't even need kavanah. It's a suffix. Oh. But even if I need kavanah, maybe I said it. Maybe I said it, and maybe I had kavanah. Maybe I had kavanah. In other words, it's a svek sveka. Another one, maybe I don't even need kavanah. That's suffix number, because maybe it's a suffix whether I need kavanah. Suffix number one, whether I even need kavanah. So, but even if I do need kavanah, maybe I had kavanah. I'm assuming when I had kavanah, it's a svek sveka. And since there's a rule by svek sveka, you go to kula, svek sveka, you go to kula. So why does Mogen Avraham say, why does the Primigodim say that in a suffix, whether I said, whenever I had kavanah, I have to go over it because suffix derives from kumra, it shouldn't be a suffix. It should be a svek sveka. That's the kasha, that beautiful kasha. If it's really a suffix, every mitzvah svek kavanah is a suffix, it should be a svek sveka, it should be mutter. That's the next, all right. The third thing, next page. Let's go to the next page. It says, with Os Beis. The page, it says on top of the page, Shin Pei Aleph. Shitas Rambam, in mitzvah svek kavanah. Shitas Rambam, in mitzvah svek kavanah. So that we mentioned before, there's a stira in the seems like the Rambam. Because the Rambam in the halacha in matzah, he says over there on the right side, where it says on the middle of the page, imansu lecho matzah, he says he's yoytze b'shofer, and he yoytze b'mitzah shofer at yishkav lotzis. So, does he need kabbalah? Doesn't need kabbalah. So they're all bothered by this question. Seems like the more equates the two things. So he brings down the next paragraph of Magen Mishnah. He says he wants to answer the kasha of the Rambam. He says the difference is the matzah and shofar. He says, well, even though it seems like in the Gemara it's one din, but he says it can be mechalik ben hadvarim. He says, what's the difference? He wants to say what's the difference between the two things. So the Magen Mishnah says in the bottom paragraph on the right side, the bottom paragraph says osal. The Magen Mishnah calls it the came to the shofar leka ela shmiel bovad sor kavod. Mashenki matzah sheish bo maaseh. So he was distinguished between doing an action, eating is an action. You know, most people, it's not that hard, but it is an action. It's physical. So I'm physical. Shmiya, I'm listening. You know, listening is passive. Listening is passive. So it's since it's passive, I'm not doing anything. So maybe you need Kabbalah. So the Shaila is, that's a svara that the Magen Mishnah comes up with. He says, well, something which is active, so actually doing something physical, then you're yotzei without having real kabbana to the mitzvah. Even they forced me to do it, but I did something physical. Since I did something physical, that's enough for the kabbana. I didn't really have kabbana for the mitzvah. So how was that really good? Just because I did something physical. Big deal. I did something physical, but I had no kabbana for mitzvah. If mitzvah sweepers kabbana, it's physical, very nice. You know, guy who did a workout, he ate matzah, not easy matzah, you know, especially it's hard on your teeth, right? So big deal. So I ate matzah. So why is that supposed physical? But if you didn't have kabbana, I didn't have kabbana. Why is that make kabbana? That's the question. What's the Magen Mishnah mean? That's a very difficult svara, the Magen Mishnah says. What does it mean? Because I did a maaseh, and the other one just listen, and listening is not an action. So what? Where do you get it from? Why does that come up? One more svara in the Rambam, Ketz Mishnah, next page. Because the Mishnah, if we have it on the next page over in the Ran, and page it says Shin Pei Beis. Shin Pei Beis on the right hand side, Os Beis. Over there, Haran Kosov Rosh Hashanisham, Kosov Akesha Mishnah, Melchus Shafer, the Kevin Nenebachidos Matzah, Yotza Avshalo Kivin. So he gives a new svar. He says, because you had Hanoah. You had Hanoah. A guy enjoys Matzah, yeah, physical. It's more than just doing something with your body. But he says, you have Hanoah, person, you know, you ate something. You fill up your stomach a little bit, so it's Hanoah. Every Achila is called Hanoah. Achila is Hanoah. The Gemara says, you know, the Torah asks Achila, it means it asks the Hanoah. Sometimes it only asks Achila, but it's Hanoah. But since it's Hanoah, when you did it, then you're Yotzer. Mashenkein, a shofar is not Hanoah. Even though there is also a person who likes music, he's doing it, you know, some people are musical, they like the sound of the music. People, you know, they listen all day, some guys are listening all day, even in cheer, they're listening to music. But that's not a physical Hanoah. A physical Hanoah is different, again. So we have two distinctions in Rambam. How are these making it to kabbana though? You know, we're talking about the level of having kabbana to do a mitzvah. Big deal. The Magen Mishnah is physical. The Ketzer Mishnah says, well, it's Hanoah. So what? So we have such a concept in Aveira. We have in Aveira such a concept. If a person is not mechavan to do an Aveira, ain't mechavan to do an Aveira, and it did Aveira, so you're not over. This is my focus in Tanoyim, Rav Yehuda, Rav Shimon. We passed him that if you didn't have kabbalah to do the Aveira, you did Aveira, you're not over. But in certain, in Yonim, where the Torah says that you shouldn't have Hanoah, we ate the not kosher food. Torah says don't eat not kosher food. So there, even if you're not mechavan, even if you thought it was kosher, it's not kosher, it's an Aveira. Because there it says Shekein Nana. So in Averas we find such a concept. In Averas, because the Torah says the Avera is also because the body got something bad from it. Like we said, there's a skula. Because we said before, there's certain skulas where you do a mitzvah. So Rabbi Yoni said, you do a mitzvah, you get certain brownie points. You did an Avera of eating not kosher. It's matamte mezaleh. It hurts you. So in that, total of not knowing it, maybe total of misaseh, maybe it's not also. But if you're in Muhammad, you didn't have kavana, where it's okay, so that's enough to say. That's why is this making mitzvahs or kabbalah? How does it get up the ladder that just because you have Hanoah that makes it into a kabbalah? There's no kabbalah over here. The guy didn't have one. The guy, the goyim are forcing the guy to eat. The guy's sitting over there in a dungeon over there in Moscow, and the goyim are pushing matzah down his mouth. So he's got kabbalah. Oh, he has Hanoah. He's enjoying the matzah so much, you know? So what does that make it into a kabbalah? How does it make it? Okay, that's what we have to understand. So it's a couple of questions we got to understand over here. Now, this, why is there a difference between the Rabbanan and Rabbanan? How do we understand the Prima Godin? Is it the Sufi? Why is it the Sfexfegan? So those are some of the questions we have to try to conquer over here. Now, again, what is the whole source of this din about needing Kabbana? Now, where does it say in the Torah in Kabbana? Where does it say in the Torah, you know, Mitzvah Srikas Kabbana? Where does it say in the Torah you got to have Kabbana? It's a nice thing. The Torah says you gotta sit in sukkah. The Torah says you gotta take a lulav. The Torah says you gotta do a shofar. But where does it say you gotta come on? Who says that, right? So Rosh Hashanah says he thinks it's a svara. He thinks it's a svara. Svara Pshuti says the guy's not mechaben. He says you're not mechaben. He doesn't think you're not connected to the mitzvah. That's what he thinks it's a svara Pshuti. He says you're not mechaben. If you're not mechaben, so then you did a mitzvah. That's not thought doing a mitzvah. He didn't think about it. The guy he's daydreaming and somehow he ate something. Hey, that's a mitzvah. Come on, it's not a mitzvah. Okay, well maybe the rabbanim were not so machmir. That's what he says a svara. Thinks maybe it's a svara. But I saw in a sefer, a Gabaltic sefer, you go next page, Imre Bina, the one of those later pages, I think about the fourth page, Imre Bina was the grandfather of Rav Shlomo Zalman Auerbach. I'm sure you heard of Rav Shlomo Zalman Auerbach, the great poysik from Shalayim, from the greatest poysikim of our generation, Rav Shlomo Zalman. His grandfather was the first Ashkenazic chief rabbi in Yerushalayim. He was in like the 1860s, 1870s. The first Ashkenazic posek in our generation was the grandfather of Rav Shlomo Zalman, Rav Meir Auerbach, and he was a goy olam, a great genius, and he wrote Svarim, also Imre Bina. And Imre Bina, in one of his tshuvas, he talks about the inyan of Tzrichas Kavanah in a mitzvah. Now he says, he's having it on that fourth page. Recent Prima Godim, she calls it Lohami Deraisa Rachman Rabbanim. So he quotes over here the Prima Godim, which we saw before, that Rebbe Kager says that Prima Godim had a suffix when it's Deraisa Rabbanim. He's quoting the Prima Godim, I guess he's assuming that the Prima Godim held it's Rabbanim. The whole thing of Mitzvah Tzrichas Kavanah, he quotes now from the Prima Godim, he says it's Rabbanim. He says, but there's several questions on this Prima Godim. Several big questions on the question if it's a Rabban. Don't forget, the Prima Godim, from having poskim in Shulchan Aruch, according to Rebbe, he said he had a suffix when he did Kavana. According to the Imre Bina, he thinks that he was paskin, that you don't need Kavana really with the Raisa, and he only needed the Rabbanim. Now, he says, we have several questions from the Gemara. We'll go on one question, enough to look at the next question from the Gemara. He says, the Gemara says, Hayoshin b'shmini b'sukkah. Now, we know, of course, in Chutz Lars, we also sit Shmini Atzeres, so that's some Hasidim, don't sit there, different Minhagim, but non-Hasidim usually in the Chutz Lars, we do sit in the Sukkah the 8th day. But we're talking about, because in the Chutz Lars, it's a suffix where the 8th day is or the 7th day, so that's when we sit in the Sukkah, right, in Chutz Lars. But in Israel, of course, in Israel, we don't sit in Sukkah on the 8th day. So, but what when Mursa was in sleeping, the Gemara talked about, so what if I slept in Sukkah on the 8th day? You know, you want to enjoy the Sukkah. He wants Ayashim b'sukkah b'shmini. So the Gemara discusses that maybe you're over the Isser of Baal Toysiv. There's Isser of Teira, not to be Moisiv in the mitzvah. You can't add on to, you got four pair in a tefillin, you got four boxes, you want to add a fifth box. So, well, Baal Toysiv, the Torah says, Los Toysiv, Los Sifu, not allowed to add. So the Gemara says, 1 second, there's 7 days of sukkahs. You want to make an 8-day sukkahs? Well, no, that's you can't do that. It's Baal Toysiv. So the Gemara says, Ayoshim b'shmini b'sukkah yilke. He should get malchus. He goes in and he's sleeping. Same thing, what's he eating? Say, you should get malchus. So the Gemara over there says, well, it depends. He said, over there, the Gemara says that Mavur, in that page, the mitzvah srikas kabana, it's okay. Now the Gemara says, sleeping in sukkah that night, I enjoy sukkah. So, in Israel, it's very pleasant. I was in Israel too, and at sukkahs, and it was actually too warm almost to sleep in a sukkah. I was in a hotel there in the Jerusalem Garden, and if the Jerusalem Garden Hotel is in the middle of town right next to Ramada, and I was there and sukkah, it was so warm. I'm telling you, it was almost too warm to sleep in the sukkah. I had to go inside, get air conditioning to go and cool off a little bit. It was so warm, and I slept on a roof. There was a roof over there, and with a lot of beds on the roof, and we slept over there. And my family, my wife and others, they slept in a room in a hotel. But I remember sleeping outside on a roof. It was very, very beautiful. So that was sukkah. That wasn't shmini. It was during sukkahs. But what if a guy slept on the 8th day? Now, the Gemara says, well, it would depend. If mitzvah srichas kavana, the guy on the 8th day is not mechaven to be yotza mitzvah of sitting in sukkah. He said because he enjoys it. It's a warm day and he likes the outdoors, as long as, not mosquitoes, he'll enjoy it. So that's okay, So that's okay. But if mitzvah ain't srichas kavana, the Gemara says it'll be over on Baltosi. Mitzvah ain't srichas kavana, it'll be over on Baltosi. So the question is asked by the Mephorshim, as Rabbi Bina says, 1 second. Mitzvah srichas kavana, we said then, you weren't mechaven, you just wanted to enjoy the sukkah. So it's okay. because you weren't mechaven. But he says, if you hold the prima donna, says the whole idea of mitzvahs shrichas kavana is only with the rabbanan. And with the raisa, you don't need kavana. You're yotze the mitzvah without kavana. Remember, you need your yotze the mitzvah without kavana. So if that's the case, says the rabbina. So why can the Gemara say that if you didn't have kavana, it's okay to sleep in the sukkah, not over on Baltosim? But midiraisa, according to the prima donna, you don't need kavana. So sleeping in a sukkah without kavana, I should still be over on Baltosim. I should be over on Baltosim because even though I'm not mechaven to be doing a mitzvah, but I'm still sleeping in a sukkah, and since it doesn't midiraisa need any kavana, I should be over the Yisur Torah of Baltosim. You follow the question? Again, if the Gemara says it would depend, but a mitzvah is on the same thing. If mitzvah srikas kavana, it's fine to sleep in the sukkah because I'm not mechamen for mitzvah, I'm mechamen because it's nice weather and I want to enjoy it, it's okay. But if mitzvah srikas kavana, I'm in trouble. And whereas if mitzvah srikas kavana, because then you shouldn't be sleeping out there because you're over Baltosim, yeah.
Yeah, but it's only a mitzvah on sukkah.
Yeah, the Gemara talks about over Shlomis Mana, the Gemara says Rabbi Siegel, the Gemara says Shlomis Mana, boy kavana. The Gemara is going to say Shlomis Mana, boy kavana. The Gemara's answer that Shlomis Mana, but the rest ain't only kavana altogether. But, yeah, but the more discussed about Shalom Isman, maybe also the mitzvah. Question would be Yotze the mitzvah without kavana. But the Gemara still is saying that you could be Yotze, even Shalom Isman, that the Gemara held at this time, Shalom Isman, you can also be Yotze. You can also be over and about, like the Gemara says. So,
if kavana,
what? Well, you're passive. You know, you have no kavanah at all. I'm not kavanah for mitzvah. I'm kavanah to sleep there. Yeah. Well, the Gemara says if we go over Baltosim. The Gemara says sleeping in a sukkah shmini is you're over Baltosim. No, the Gemara says it without kavanah. The Gemara says fakir if mitzvah ain't shrichas kavanah, then you're in trouble. Even though that's the Gemara says because you did a mitzvah. Without kavanah, if mitzvah ain't shrichas kavanah, you did a mitzvah. Sleeping in sukkah isn't, in other words, it's like putting five boxes in a night villain. Sleeping, making 8 day sukkahs is making changing a 7 day sukkah into an 8 day sukkahs. I change it. If I sleep in Hanukkah in a sukkah, maybe it's not baltoisim. But I guess adding on to the day, perhaps that would be baltoisim. Gemara says that. So why? But the question is, why would it be baltoisim? Why would it be baltoisim if mitzvahs don't need kavanah mideraisa? So. You don't need kavanah mideraisa. So even if I'm not mechaven, I was not a mitzvah lechor. I should be over baltosim. So that's the question that's raised over here on that shita. Now, one more question, and we'll try to get the answers. At the bottom, he talks about a cotton and doing a mitzvah. Okay, the bottom of this page, a cotton. What about a cotton? A cotton we teach to do mitzvahs. That's called chinuch, right? A cotton you teach it to do mitzvahs. Now, he brings a question about teaching a cotton to do mitzvahs. He says, how do you teach a cotton to do mitzvahs? That if you want to teach a cotton to do a mitzvah, he brings a question from the Turi Evan. The Turi Evan was the Turi Evan, Shagas Aryeh, Sefer Yeruah and Rosh Hashanah, and Turi Evan, he says that a cotton has no kavana. A cotton, is das, is not called das. Das of a cotton is not called das. So he says, how do you teach a cotton? Why do you teach him to do a mitzvah? He's not doing the mitzvah. If a mitzvah is srichas kavana, then a cotton shouldn't be, you're not training him. You can't take a kid and give him an apple instead of an eser, right? You gotta give him an eser. You know, arba minim, I only got three and I'll substitute my lemons for the, no, you don't do that, right? You can't do that. Instead of having a palm branch, I'll give him a baseball bat. You don't do that. You'd rather have the baseball bat, but it's a mitzvah. So if you need a kavana to be yotze the mitzvah, you need a kavana to be yotze the mitzvah. So then how could I give a cotton to do a mitzvah? There's no mitzvah circus kavana. Cotton has no das as a Turi Evan. So how am I give motzi? How can I be motzi the mitzvah? That's the question. Okay, so we have several points I wanted to go over right now. Let's go over the chazer the points and try to give the answer. Number one is mitzvahs. They need kavana. They need kavana. Okay, machlokes. The question is, what's the source to that then? Well, maybe it's a svara. Rav Osher Weiss thinks maybe it's logic. Maybe it makes sense, right? Okay, perhaps. Then, the second point is, There's the Rishon Rabbanan. Why the Rabbanan didn't make it into a mitzvah? They said you don't need it. The Rabbanan don't need it. So why not? Why should it be that you don't need it? Thirdly, we have the Rambam Shita. What does the Rambam really hold? Mitzvah Srikas on main Srikas Kavanah. He says on one hand, the matzah you're going to without Kavanah, shofar you need Kavanah, right? Last question we have a question in Mitzvah Srikas Kavanah and Srikas Kavanah. We said, what's with the Gemara about Yoshim B'Shmini B'Sukkah? He said, sleeping in a sukkah and the Shmini, extending the sukkahs, it's over, pending whether you need Kavanah or need Kavanah. But how could that be if your mitzvahs don't need Kavanah with deraisa? So every time you do a mitzvah, even without Kavanah, it's like doing the mitzvah. I still extended the mitzvah and it should be Batoisa. Right? And then the last question was Tori Evans' question. Why do I train a cotton to do mitzvahs if he's not really doing the mitzvah? If mitzvah drinks Kavanah, the cotton's not doing the mitzvah. It's like giving the cotton, an apple instead of a lemon, instead of an ester. You're substituting the mitzvah. The mitzvah shrinkers got one. I'm not doing the whole thing. So what's the point of this? Well, why teach him? We're trying to train a kid to do the mitzvah. You're training him, but you're training, kid. Like somebody said, don't let the people daven Meyer tonight at 4:30. One of the rabbis said, don't do that. I said, then they'll think you can daven Meyer early. No. I said, no, learn. You're allowed to daven Meyer after block a mitzvah, right? Friday, a lot of people do that, right? In the summer, when it's, when the days are, very long, people don't want to eat dinner, so late. So they daven, early for a block of mincha, they daven 6 o'clock mincha meyer, and they make their suda, right? So now you're going home, and the yeshiva, the guy's going home from the, because the PTA meeting. So make a meyer learning. It's not every day you should daven so early, but today I said there's a reason to do it, right? So that's why I thought maybe it's a good idea. Okay, now when I'm trying to approach this, the answer the following. We'll go to the logic. The Ibn Bina has a very interesting sheet over here. The Ibn Bina we talked about, the next page. The Ibn Bina wants to say a beautiful shot in the whole idea of a mitzvah srikas kavanah. That's what I want to share with you, the Ibn Bina. He says, the Ibn Bina, that he thinks that the source of the mitzvah srikas kavanah, okay, he brings, that's the next page. V'yesh Lomar. You have in that page V'yesh Lomar. It's a very, very beautiful introduction to the idea of a new idea, an Einfall, a very interesting idea. In the middle of that page, I think it's page 5, I don't know the number of the pages, but it says in that page, in the middle of the page, it says V'yesh Lomar. V'yesh Lomar, im nomar mitzvah srikas kavanah midiraisa, it's possible to say mitzvah srikas kavanah. We had a shaila, whether it's deraisa, whether it's derabanan, it's a question. Whether it's the rice of Rabbanah, we saw many people go to end a suffering death. Because of the cotton, shaper niskayim a mitzvah v'poyel af beheder a kavanah. But it could be that by a cotton, he could be yotze even without the kavanah. Dinei Reisi, he brings a sefer zichron teres Moshe from the Chaya Odom, from the great poskim that we used to, before we learned the Mishnah Berurah, before that the Chaya Odom was like the halacha, everybody learned the Chaya Odom. So he brings it from Sefer Charedim. After the man there mitzvah tzrikas ain't tzrikas kavana moide mitzvah esay hu la'avdo b'cholavavchem. Oh, so he says that there is a mitzvah in the Torah la'avdo b'cholavavchem. Say nishma la'avdo b'cholavavchem. Cholavavchem kol nafshecha. You have to serve Hashem b'cholavavchem kol nafshecha. So that's the mitzvah. So to serve Hashem, that's a mitzvah. B'cholavavchem kol nafshecha. The Rambam I think wants to say that's why tefillah is deraisa b'cholavavchem. The Rambam says that's not deraisa tefillah davening. But the idea says the Sefer Charedim that la'avdo b'cholavavchem. He says that's the idea of a mitzvah. La'avdo b'cholavavchem. Al kol mitzvahs rak the enum avatal a mitzvah bittel mitzvah esay as those b'cholalis. In other words, a general rule: you have to serve Hashem b'cholavavchem. Remember, we said before also the Talmid Rabbeinu Yehuda said that if you do a mitzvah without kavana, it's like not a good thing. They don't get schoolas mitzvah, they don't get schar mitzvah. It's not a good thing. Then now we're saying really. Well, you know what? You're supposed to serve Hashem b'chol avcha. Now, if you do a mitzvah without any kavanah, that's not really serving Hashem b'chol avcha. God gave you a mitzvah. You're supposed to, it's a good thing, right? You got a good thing, you want to enjoy it. It's like a guy, it's like you want to, you went out, you ate a good steak. You don't want to be wearing sometimes you got to wear a mask because corona, but you don't want to cover your eyes and eat the steak, You want to enjoy it. You see it, oh, it's schmack, let's eat, right? So the mitzvah, b'chol avavchem, tells you you have to have mitzvah, you have to have kavod. He says, the mitzvah says of the chol avavchem. So what he wants to explain is the following. He wants to say that the question is b'chol avavchem, does that go into every mitzvah? That's the question. Is that really a part of every mitzvah? In other words, you have to serve Hashem. So can you do a mitzvah without b'chol levavchem? Because that's a general rule. Now you're doing a mitzvah, if you don't have b'chol levavchem, so maybe it's a general rule, but as it goes in specific into every mitzvah essay. So then he says that he thinks that's the shayla. B'chol levavchem, b'chol nafshchem, that's the shayla. Does that really go into every mitzvah? Is there, now every mitzvah I do I have to have this kavana b'chol levavchem, b'chol nafshchem? So if that's the rule, so then he says that it's important then, b'chol levavchem, it really is a part of the mitzvah, so then I wouldn't be yotzei the mitzvah. Furthermore, he says that could be, it's a general rule, but it doesn't go in specific, because a mitzvah is a mitzvah. And then even the b'chol levavchem is a general rule, I will serve Hashem. But it doesn't go into, every essay didn't have this rule, b'chol levavchem. So it's a general rule, b'chol levavchem, or is it no? Since there is such a rule, b'chol levavchem, is it a part of every mitzvah? So he wants to say the following. A very interesting chiddush from the Yerubina.
Is he making this up?
What?
All
the b'chol levavchem is a mitzvah, but every mitzvah is that a prat, is that a detail that you need that b'chol levavchem to be yotzei that mitzvah.
Well, this is the chiddush of chiddush in those words.
Well, the shayla is that those words apply in every mitzvah. That's the shayla. B'chol levavchem, the Rambam says it goes on the table. Well, it says because that's a service. You have to serve Hashem, and if you don't do a mitzvah, that's a way of serving Hashem. That's what he said. That's part of service to Hashem. So you have to serve Hashem, and if you get a mitzvah, so you're supposed to serve Hashem, and you're not serving Him. So that's how he understands it. So he wants to say a very interesting chiddush. He says, this could be the machloikis. Now, the b'chol levavchem, so he wants to say, that could be, he wants to understand maybe how a kotan would be okay. Interesting chab. He wants to say that if it's a part of the mitzvah, but there is a mitzvah, let's say, of blowing shofar, the mitzvah of eating matzah, and sitting and so, what are all these mitzvahs? Now, the b'chol levavchem tells me that there's a mitzvah, but besides that mitzvah, the b'chol levavchem tells me I should be doing the mitzvah the proper way. Now, he says, though, that if that's the rule, let's say I did the mitzvah without kavana. I did it without kavana. So then I'm really messing it up because I'm blowing the b'chol levavchem. I'm doing the mitzvah without kavana, it's really bad because I'm blowing the b'chol levavchem. So by doing it bad, he has a chiddush. He's doing it so bad, it's a chiddush, he says, then he's a big chiddush. You got to know that it's a rabbinic chiddush. He wants to say it would be like a mitzvah of aveira. So an aveira, I'm doing an aveira. I'm doing a mitzvah, and I'm like making fun of the mitzvah. I'm doing God's mitzvah. You know, I'm eating the matzah, but I'm not doing it for Pesach. I'm doing it because you know, I like matzah. You know, all right. That's like he says that you're b'chol levavchem. If you're not yotzei b'chol levavchem, you do the mitzvah. It's like doing a real bad thing. So Meili says that you wouldn't be yotzei. You wouldn't be yotzei. So if b'chol levavchem is a general rule, it doesn't go specifically into this mitzvah. So then it wouldn't be bad. You have to see the Imre Bidis Chiddush. I'm not masber the whole Chiddush right now. I'm saying b'kitzer. But he wants to prove it from under a Rambam. He wants to prove this big Chiddush. He says basically it's on a Rambam and a Rashba. That's what he claims. But anyway, that's his Chiddush. So he says if that's the rule, so then we can understand. He says that b'chol levavchem says that's the rule. You got to do it b'chol levavchem. And if that's part of the mitzvah, so it's very bad. If that's the mitzvah, you're blowing it. But if there is no, b'chol levavchem is just a general rule, it doesn't go into specific mitzvahs, so then I didn't blow it, it's not so bad, so I just didn't do it. I didn't have the mitzvah, so I don't have b'chol levavchem, but I don't blow the mitzvah. So he wants to say by a kotan, for a kotan, well, he can't have the b'chol levavchem. So he can't have that prat, because he doesn't have b'chol levavchem, in other words, concentration. A kotan, we said, he doesn't really have das. That's the Gemara saying, right? Torah Yevon said he doesn't have das. How do you give him the... So he says he doesn't have that ability to concentrate. So the mitzvah is a mitzvah. The reason we have another rule, b'chol levavchem, that... So he says we can give him the chinuch on that mitzvah, but he won't have the b'chol levavchem because he can't have it. It's not shayach to him. B'chol levavchem is not shayach. That's what I say. So by a kotan, it's shayach to give him the mitzvah to do, because the b'chol levavchem is an overriding rule, but that don't apply to the kotan. So that's what he wants to say. So that he wants to say could be the machlokes also, whether mitzvahs deraisa, whether so that could be different between deraisa and rabbanan. Also, we said before that in deraisa, so then there, if you hold that the b'chol levavchem is a part of every mitzvah. So the rabbanan didn't say that. The rabbanan said no. The rabbanan made it. They didn't make it so chomer like a deraisa. The b'chol levavchem says like a general rule. It's a general rule. So then it doesn't not accurate in the mitzvah. So not makim in the mitzvah, so mainly it could be in the rabbanan. And then you can say this chilukim also we said before. Once we said it's the rabbanan, we can say svaras in the rabbanan. We can say that the rabbanan made distinctions, like the Magen Mishnah said, whether he had anah, like physical, not physical. Once it's the rabbanan, it's okay. So the same idea we said that cotton could be different. Cotton, you only have to. In other words, it's an overriding rule of the Halavacha, which falls into the mitzvah, and it can really be a part of the mitzvah. That's not shaykh to a kohen because you can't have that part. So they gave him the mitzvah. There's mitzvahs of Torah, sukkah, and luluv, and shofar. So that the kohen can do. But the Halavacha is not shaykh to him, so they didn't give that. The Torah didn't give it to him. He doesn't have dash yet. So it's true. Every mitzvah has this. So that's what he wants to say to Pshat, Dim Rebina. So he says that's what he wants to understand. Maybe that's the Pshat. He says, now that. Talking about the Gemara when it said you're over on the Gemara with about Baltosif, but the Gemara said over there about this one last point. You said that you're over on Baltosif if you need Kavanah, you're not over on Baltosif. Need Kavanah, not over Baltosif. So you said, well, one second. What do you mean? We said if Kavanah, according to the Prevagana, is only the Rabbanan, so you should still be over Baltosif. By adding, doing the mitzvah, you should still be over Baltosif, because even though you didn't have Kavanah, according to Prevagana, you don't need Kavanah in the Raisa. So he brings a very interesting Tosfos in Sukkah that says a very interesting Kiddush. Tosfos says that the Rabbanan, when they added something into a mitzvah, the Rabbanan added something to a mitzvah, they said, if you don't do that, the Rabbanan not Yotze. The Rabbanan said, so not Yotze altogether. So if the Rabbanan added Kavanah to a mitzvah, so then you don't have the Kavanah, so then you're not Yotze even the Raisa. That's what Tosfos says in Sukkah Daf Gimel. So that's why he wants to save Shad. That's why. With that, he said the answer to the Gemara by Sukkah, Yoshe Mishmini Sukkah, you get Malkis if Mitzvah Tzrichas Kavanah, we said that you wouldn't get Malkis. We said, why wouldn't you get Malkis? You're still, according to Prima Godin, Deraisa, you did a mitzvah. No. Since the Rabbanan said you need Kavanah, you're not Yotze the mitzvah, you can't be over Matosim. So the Rabbanan said it, you can't be over. That's what he wants to say to you, Rabbi. You wouldn't be over. And that's also, he says, by a cotton, you say also the same idea. By a cotton, since you can't have kavanah, so it's not, according to that, you don't have kavanah, so it's not shaykh to him. So there's no chia for them to have the kavanah. So this is not, anyway, the mitzvah, like we said before, the mitzvah can do, and the kavanah he can't have, so at least let him do the mitzvah. And that's a little bit. What's by who? By a cotton?
In the case of Tuli Vizotin, it's not over there. If you give me money, I'm forcing you to take money, so I give the item back.
Yeah.
So the start is that Tuli Vizotin is kind of deep, and Tuli Vizotin is not. But over here, nothing's forcing you to even have a mitzvah.
Well, the Rambam says that forcing you to the mitzvah is what you really want to do is the mitzvah. The Rambam says in Hilchas Gerushin, because you really want to do the mitzvah, that forces you to the mitzvah.
Okay.
The Rambam says you really want to do the mitzvah. The Rambam says every time you do a mitzvah, but again, he says you really want to do the mitzvah. That's forcing you to the mitzvah. That's the Rambam. He compares that to Tuli Yoy. He says the guy gave you money. You got to pay him back. But that God gave you a mitzvah, you want to do that mitzvah. That's what the Rambam says. When you want to do something because the Torah told you to do it, you want to do it. Anyway, that's for Kitzer. We try to cover a lot of bases, but I hope we did okay. I don't know. We tried with two different computers. We tried with different speakers. And I don't know if we did it too good, but we tried. Okay.